Welcome to this tripod headstand tutorial. I'm George Choy, and I just want to acknowledge you for turning up today to deepen your practice. Now, this tripod headstand routine, I'm going to teach you step by step, so it is suitable for beginners. No matter where you are, you can do this. It's a lot easier than you think it is. It's just knowing the right steps and where to put your hands and so on. Okay. Now, I personally love doing challenging yoga poses like this because it builds strength. You get such a great sense of achievement once you've done it, and it looks really cool. So that's really good. And if you want to further your yoga practice, then click the link in the description below. Now, when you're doing a challenging move like this, I find it really good to borrow from Tony Robbins' teachings and get in the right state. So let's start thinking like an athlete. I want you to say after me, all I need is within me now. All I need is within me now. All I need is within me now. Good. Now, close your eyes. I invite you to do that if you feel like doing it. And imagine yourself, just picture yourself in your mind in the tripod headstand. Imagine what it feels like. See yourself doing it. Good. All right, let's get started. So with the setup, if you feel concerned at all that you might fall over doing this pose, then I recommend you put yourself about 1 foot away from the wall. So put your back about 1 foot away from the wall. And then that way, there's still a little bit of flexibility for you to be off center and to adjust so you can get your alignment right without instantly touching the wall. But it's not so far away that you would, fall onto the floor. It can be a little bit uncomfortable on your head. I don't recommend using a cushion. Something like this is too thick. What I would actually recommend is just using a very thin blanket, or you can put your head on a small foam mat, something like that. Or, I'm okay just actually with the carpet. If you have, any retinal injuries or neck pain or lower back pain, if you have high blood pressure or low blood pressure, or you're pregnant, or it's currently your moon cycle, then perhaps this is not the right time for you to do this practice. And if you've got any wrist pain, definitely it is not the right time for you. So let's warm up. So let's just do a few things on the wrist. Obviously, you should be able to already hold yourself in, say, a plank position that you can take that strain on your wrist. So the first thing is where to put your hands. You're going to put your head down, and then you're going to put your hands and make sure that your hands aren't too close to your head. You want them further back. What I like to do is actually just lift my arms up and then put them down. So I'm going to put my head here. I'm going to lift my arms up, put them there. That feels comfortable for me. My forearms seem upright. Then walk yourself towards you. That's it. And then if you want to lift one up, you can. If you want to lift the other one and touch them, you can. You can even try putting one leg up if you want. Or just going halfway to there. Or maybe if that's too much, you can just move one leg off. And then eventually, you can go all the way up. Squeeze your glutes, squeeze your legs together. Slowly reverse the move. So how did you do? I hope it went well. Please let me know how far you got in the comments. And if you want to take it further, then have a look in the description. And there's also a crow tutorial of mine. You can check that out. If you want to go from crow to headstand to back to crow again, you can try that. And I'll see you all next week. Namaste.